Sorry, if this review seems very odd and all over the place and feels like I'm really trying to make it entertaining, it's because I am, because I'm suffering, like, with... I didn't sleep well last night. It took me forever to fall asleep, and I underslept because of the time I had to get up. I'm just trying to power through this video up until, like, you know, so that way tonight, when I get full amounts of rest, you know, the next video and all that stuff, they can be back to full energy. But here, I'm, like, trying to make it look like I have the full energy, and so if it's coming across as, like, fake and artificial, I completely understand.
Yeah, the Lord of the Rings. I'm tired of nobody talking about it, man.
All right, guys, I hear you. It says The Hobbit, it's not Lord of the Rings. But you know what? We don't care. We're using it for the video, okay? I was gonna try to say something like really cool there, but then I couldn't think of anything. Hey, my name is King, and today we're taking a look at The Lord of the Rings, The Fellowship of the Ring. So we just did 8 weeks of Harry Potter, and so I took a week off, and now we're coming back with it with Lord of the Rings, and right after we finish Lord of the Rings, it's on this side of the camera. We're gonna be going right into The Hobbit, and then we're gonna be ranking those all. Also, I got you. Listen. Big announcement. This is day one in the streak of daily uploads. We're trying our best. If I make it past 10, if I can make it into the double digits, we're throwing a party, okay? And then, you know, if I break the streak, you know, then I get punished. So let's hope I don't break the streak. So I'm tired of nobody talking about The Lord of the Rings. Yes, it gets talked about every time, like, someone brings up, like, awards contender movies and, like, the big franchise stuff, but no one talks about it. Just, like, they casually will bring up the MCU, or they'll bring up Star Wars, or they'll bring up... what other ones? Harry Potter, the DCEU. Come on, like, there's so many things. There's so many big franchises that everybody talks about, but nobody wants to talk about this. Now, a lot of people are like,
oh my God, Star Wars, oh my God, Marvel.
You're all wrong. You're wrong. You're wrong. If your answer is not Lord of the Rings, you're wrong. What Marvel movie won Best Picture? Exactly, you can't think of nothing. What Star Wars movie won Best Picture? Oh, wait, they didn't. Wait, let me double check that real quick. Did any Star Wars movies won Oscars? Okay. Best score, visual effects, production design, film, and costume design, best... Oh, it was nominated. Okay. It didn't win, though. Okay. Thank God. Oh, gosh, I got so scared. Now, this, of course, is the first Lord of the Rings movie, The Fellowship of the Ring. It's a long title. So I don't know how the title of this video is going to be because, you know, there's a character limit with how long your titles can be. And so I might have to abbreviate the title. Y'all might just got to deal with that. Now, for those of you who don't know what Lord of the Rings is or you haven't seen the movies, first of all, go freaking watch Lord of the Rings because they are amazing and they're all good. And you will not be disappointed, okay? Extended editions, theatrical editions, it don't matter. Me personally, I prefer the theatrical edition just because it moves a bit faster. I like my faster paced movies, but the extended editions are equally as good, if not better. And for those of you guys who haven't seen the Lord of the Rings movies in a while, allow me to refresh your mind on what the Fellowship of the Ring is. With the help of a courageous fellowship of friends and allies, Frodo embarks on a perilous mission to destroy the legendary One Ring. They got little bios on the back for each movie because I got the 3-movie collection. Anyways, I didn't really script a review, so I don't know what to talk about next. I mean, what you want to talk about? We got the cast. We got Elijah Wood, Viggo Mortensen, Ian McKellen. Oh, I love Ian McKellen, by the way. Orlando Bloom, Sean Austin, Sean Bean, Billy Blue. Okay, there's too many names here. I'm not reading all these freaking names. Now, like, everybody knows the story of Lord of the Rings, okay? There's this ring, this one ring to rule them all. It's the most powerful ring. Men fell because they were too greedy to keep the ring for themselves rather than destroying it. So now, The Dark Lord, okay, I'm too excited, I don't know what I'm talking about. The Dark Lord, Sauron, who created the ring, is coming back, and he wants the ring to give him his full power again. And so we're left with the ring in the hands of Frodo Baggins, who is our protagonist, and he takes the ring with his buddy Sam, and the whole Fellowship of the Ring, and they go to Mordor. Now, obviously, they don't get there because, you know, it's the first movie of a trilogy, but they start the journey, okay? And yeah, this movie's fantastic. This movie is outstanding. It, like I said, it's my favorite movie, like, of the nerdy, geeky franchises. This one is not only my favorite, but I believe that it is the best. It's just, like, the way they're crafted and the writing, it just feels the most, you know, like... You know what I'm trying to say? I just can't form the words. Yeah, this movie's cheesy though. A lot of scenes are overacted and a lot of scenes are underacted. Very, very cheesy, very, very corny. The cinematography, the way certain lines are written, very cheesy, very corny, very on the nose, but it is still like, I'm still like emotionally invested in these characters and I'm laughing at stuff because, you know, it's a bit like, okay, we wouldn't do that in modern day, but you know, it makes sense in the context of this and it's a, you know, it gives that whole world its own feel. Like is that scene after Frodo and his old gang meet Aragorn and they don't know his name yet, but anyways, they meet him and Aragorn's like, yo, I'm a homie of Gandalf. We gotta go. We gotta get running because there are people here. And then you got Merry Brandybuck, Buck, never know how to pronounce his name. Like this dude showed up. Not Aragorn, but Merry did along with this homie because they were stealing crops and all that stuff. But they show up literally like 10 minutes before Aragorn shows up and they... Merry gets so involved so quickly with what's going on in this adventure. Like literally on like the second they meet it, he's all like, are we sure he knows who Gandalf is? And he's like walking. He's like, and Merry's like mad dogging him. And he's like, are we sure he knew who Gandalf was? And I was like, bro, you just showed up. You didn't even meet Gandalf at the beginning. Like, why are you so involved so fast? I feel like Sam or Frodo should be asking this, but no, he's the one who's like the most on edge about this guy. And like, and it's just the way he delivered the line, because he like walks off camera like he's literally like this. Another thing that's kind of funny is that like all like the special like ladies in here, you got Kate Blanchett and the girl from The Incredible Hulk, don't know her name. And both of them talk like this because this is how proper people talk, and because we are enlightened with magic and wise and we've lived for thousands of years. Like every, it's like the girls talk like this, like in these magical places. Like the dudes, they might have a bit like of a more proper tone, but they still sound like people, whereas these girls are all now I get it, all that stuff, I get why it's there, but it's just funny to me. Like it's just, it always gets me off guard. Then of course you got the scene with Gandalf where he's like, you shall not pass, and he stabs the staff into the ground. Every time he says that I bust out laughing, not because like I think it's like idiotic or funny, but because like I'm just like, yeah, Gandalf, and I like laugh out of joy and stuff. But yeah, this is just one of those movies where so much happens that it's like hard to recall right after you watch it. Like I just finished rewatching it literally like an hour ago, so it's like fresh in my memory, and like there's so much because it's 3 hours, and so there's just so many scenes going on inside of my head, and I'm like, oh my gosh. But I know y'all just want me to give it a score, so I'll just tell you what the score is, and I will say that The Lord of the Rings, The Fellowship of the Ring, gosh, that's a long title, it is God tier. But if you want my unbiased without nostalgic type look on it, I would probably say it's an 8 out of 10 in terms of quality. But with that being said, guys, go watch Lord of the Rings, The Fellowship of the Ring if you haven't. Even if you have, go rewatch it, because every time I finish these movies, I'm like, I just want to start the next one, but then realize I don't have time to do all that. But, you know, I can't wait to talk about Two Towers with you guys next week. Yeah. Well, anyways, guys, I hope that you guys liked this video. If you did, you already know what to do. Stop our stream! That like button. Subscribe today to become a royal and hit the notification bell to make sure you get more awesome videos just like this one. That's it for me today, guys. Roll out.